Yin. Yin, you got to go to your village. But you weren't sure if you were going to do that at first.
No.
But you did. And you had some interesting experiences. You want to share a little bit about? Or is that what you want to share about? Okay. Okay. Well, you're calm.
Okay. My village is, it's one of those hotspot village, and my family has been, I think as far as I could remember, has been a big part in when it comes to dealing with the monster in the Vietnamese.
They're troublemakers too. There's a lot of talk.
So when I went back to my village, I was really, really scared of the authority. Cause I think I was around 9 or 10 that I came here, and I still remember, like, ever since I was just a little baby, of the soldiers going around in the dark with their guns, big guns, and just in the uniform and boots and all of that. So I was like terrified, because I know that I'm gonna have to face them here from our group and what Tuck had to go through. And so, and I had really bad images too, because they come and ransacked our home so many times. Even though I was little, I still remember them vividly. And so when we were called, well, actually they came to our house to tell us that we had to go. And so when we went, I wasn't in my right mind, I'd say, because I was just frantically running all the situations that has happened in the past, the present, and the future. I was worried about, all those three. What is that going to do to our project currently? What's that going to do to project in the future? And what does that mean to my family? And so it was just really, really, really terrible experience. What was the question again?
Sure. What did God teach you from then on?
But through those experiences, when I got to America, I guess I kind of disconnected a little bit and numbed that pain. And so, and just, I get too caught up in trying to adapt to American culture. And the relationship between me and my mom was really, really taking the downturn. And it wasn't good at all. It was a terrible relationship with me and my mom. But experiencing all those things again, all of those emotions that came rushing back when I was there, especially in that interrogation room, I think, well, Levi might not know the reason why I was crying as they were asking all those questions. But then I cried even more the second day they interrogated me. I cried even more then. But it wasn't because of, it was mainly because of all those memories flooding back and all the pain flooding back. And I realized that my mom had to go through that for so many years. She had to face them so often. It was that experience that finally, when I got here, like, I know it. I know that she suffered a lot, but I didn't get to experience the depth of pain that she went through until this year, when I get to not only experience the conflict with the government, but also within the family, because our family is really, really broken. And I get to experience it personally, all the things that she had to go through, and it just, she became a hero after this. Before, she was someone that I really want to escape from. I was trying so hard in school just so I could escape home. But now she's my hero.
If nothing else came out of this trip than that, it would have been worth it. Yeah.